So I'm in a brand new house built in May 2020. And if we look up here, we're in the kitchen. Got a lighting point just there, another lighting point just there. And it'll be interesting to see when I take that cover down to replace that light fan, whether it's got the two plate method, which we've discussed on the channel, and there's plenty of videos on it, or the three plate method. Because when this one comes on, it also turns on this one over here. So let's just have a look at the connections in this one here and see if we can fathom out or decode what the conductors are doing. Okay, with one hand holding the camera, that's nice, a little safety guard here. So we just unclip these side pieces and drop that down, and there are our connections. So let's just take a closer look at those. So we've got two neutrals and two switching lines. If I move it around, hopefully you can see the looping terminal in the center, which we've discussed before, is not being used. So if I take a little pause now, try and work out which method you think they've used. That's right, the two plate method. So the feed, the permanent line, neutral and CPC actually went to the switch, meaning that the light fitting itself, we only have the brown switching line, the blue neutral and the CPC. And then the second one, the second neutral and second switching line goes across over to feed that light fitting over there. So they come on together. So you can see the advantage now to me in the back of this brand new fitting that I'm going to put up for the lovely lady that lives here. We've got a line, which is switching line, a CPC and a neutral. There was no extra terminal for what would have been our looping terminal. So I would have had to create my own with a connector, something like this. So I've got now the position just to put the switching line, CPC and neutral to this fitting. And then it's straight replaced because the installation was using the two plate method, taking the feed to the switch. So this is the second fitting. So if we look there, that one's already been replaced. If you can just get the focus in, that one's been replaced. So when we undo this one, we expect just to see one neutral, one switching line in the CPC as that cable comes across to here. So again, I've got to try and do this with one hand and clip there. And that's it. So we've got a CPC connection into the earth terminal, a switching line, neutral, and again, no terminations in the looping. Means we can replace this for exactly the same fitting as I've already done in the first one. Okay, so I need to strip the cable. I've just got to cut the end off this one. So you know what I'm going to do now? I'm going to attack it with my knife, and I'm going to do those conductors, and then I'm going to have loads of people in the comments go to me, why are you using a knife, Gaz? Why are you using a knife? So here we go. Here's my knife. So it goes in like so, and we go one pull like that. We go in again, and there we go. Wonderful use of a knife. So I've unscrewed the ceiling rosin pendant in the lounge, and another little bit of luck, you can see we've got one switching line, a looping terminal not being used, one neutral and one CPC. So again, they've used the two plate method, taking the feed to the switch. If I jump down, just see the back of the light fitting. Made a few modifications. I've added some insure connectors from Ideal Industries in order that I can just make these three connections and put this new light fitting back up into place. So you can already see the advantage in new installations of using the two plate method. So there it is, fitted to the ceiling, connected up, switching line, neutral and CPC all connected. Should be doing now a minor work certificate. This is not a DIY channel. This channel is for my learners to implement the two plate method and the advantages of using it in a modern electrical installation. We're gonna have a look at the consumer unit now. Obviously it's metallic, we know that. But look at that, it's May 2020, it's been installed. They've had a lot of luck, so I'm gonna flick it up. They've got a Hager board, and you can see at this end here, we've got a type 2 SPD. Double pole switch isolating the whole board, and wonderful there. You might not be able to see, I might have to zoom in a minute. Got an A-type RCCB, rated at 30 milliamps protecting these four circuits, and another A-type RCCB protecting these four. I'll be interested in looking at the arrangement of the two RCDs and what your filling is on those, whether we've got upstairs and downstairs, if you're happy with the mix, as well as having a little chat about smoke alarms being on their own breaker. Remember, leave those comments below, and I'll get back to as many as I can.